In this lecture, we're going to be talking about measuring GDP and economic growth. Now, the syllabus for this lecture includes gross domestic product. We're going to define it. We're going to ask the questions, what is it? We're also going to be learning how to measure GDP. And lastly, we're going to be evaluating GDP. We're going to look at what can GDP do for us and what can it maybe not do? Why would you not want to use GDP? So let's get started by defining GDP. Now, GDP is defined as the market value of the final goods and services produced within a country in a given period of time. Now, there are three key parts to this definition, so let's take a look at the first one. It includes the market value of all final goods and services. Let's look at an example. Let's say you go down to your regular, your local coffee store, and you buy a coffee. Well, the coffee is considered a final good because the final good is one which is consumed by its end consumer. It's bought by its end consumer. So you're the end consumer because you drink that coffee. Now, the coffee beans that your coffee store purchases is not part of GDP because it is not consumed by the store. It is used to make the coffee, which then you consume. And so an intermediate good is defined as an item that is produced by one firm, bought by another, and then used as a component of a final good. So the beans are used as a component of the coffee, which is the final good. Now, some goods such as stocks, secondhand goods, bonds, used cars, existing homes are not counted as part of GDP because they were already counted as part of GDP in the year in which it was produced. Second aspect, GDP only includes goods and services produced within a country's geographical boundaries at a particular time. So anything, for example, produced outside of Canada is not counted as part of Canada's GDP. GDP also measures production only within a given period of time, and this is usually 1 year. Now, standard of living is said to rise when GDP rises as well. Now let's take a look at the circular flow of expenditure. So we have two main institutions that are going to make up the domestic circular flow, and those are households and firms. And households and firms, they trade in two distinct markets. Now we have the factor markets and we have the goods markets. The factor markets include land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship that households provide to firms. And the goods market consists of all the goods and services that firms sell to households. Now, households spend their money in the goods market, and this is known as consumption expenditure. Now, all of this money goes directly to firms. But firms also purchase goods and services in the goods market, and this is known as investment. And normally, the goods and services that firms produce is capital, but other firms make that capital and sell it in the goods and service market. So it is said that firms, when they invest, they're still purchasing goods and services from the goods market. Now, this money goes directly back to firms. It's not going to be the same firm, but it's going to be a different firm that makes these capital goods. We have a third institution, and that is the government. And government also purchases goods and services in the form of government expenditure in the goods and service market. Now, that money again goes to firms because they're purchasing it from firms. We also have the rest of the world, and the rest of the world purchases our exports, and we purchase the rest of the world's exports as Canadian imports. And this is known as net exports, which is exports minus imports. And this money again goes directly to firms. Now, all this money is at the firms. What do they do with it? Well, they pay their employees and their board of directors and anyone else working for them. So this money goes to land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship, which is in the factor market. And from the factor market, the money goes straight to households because at the end of the day, the factor market is really composed only of households. And this is known as household income. So why do we call gross domestic product gross? Well, gross just means that we have counted the total value of the goods and services before subtracting the depreciation of capital. Now, net GDP would mean that it is after subtracting the depreciation of capital. But what is depreciation? Well, it's simply the decrease in the value of the capital that results from wear and tear. I'll give you an example. Let's say that you buy a new Lamborghini. 20 years later, it's not going to be as fast, clearly. It may even look like this, who knows? But the point is, there's going to be wear and tear, so your car's not going to be worth that much. Now with GDP, it still thinks that you're driving the same Lamborghini that you bought 20 years ago, but in reality that's not the case.